took a leap of faith and discovered her own true life purpose. Today, she is a speaker, published author, certified life purpose, relationship, and grief intuitive coach, and the founder and CEO of Soul Purpose. She is a gifted, intuitive, and certified graphologist, which means she can analyze our handwriting. Kate is passionate about helping other professionals who feel stuck in their lives and are painfully aware that something is missing. She's passionate to help them find clarity around confidence in and commitment to their true purpose in the world. In her free time, you will find Kate embracing her love of the great outdoors through running, hiking, and skiing, and her weakness for dark chocolate, dogs, and wine, but not necessarily in that order. Please join me in welcoming Kate Hagerty.
According to the Wealth Research Group, 98% of people die without ever fulfilling their dreams. It's true, 9 out of 10 people take their lifelong dreams, their biggest hopes, and the wildest desires with them to the grave. I'm going to share some tools with you today to make sure that that statistic never applies to you. I'm going to start with a story. So one evening, after thinking it over for some time, a curious 4-year-old boy named Harold decided to go for a walk in the moonlight. There wasn't a moon, and Harold needed a moon for a walk in the moonlight, and so he drew one with his big purple crayon. And he needed something to walk on, so he drew a long, straight path to make sure he wouldn't get lost, and he started out on his journey, taking his big crayon with him. In the story, Harold and the Purple Crayon, how many of you are familiar with it? Crockett Johnson introduces his reader to a curious 4-year-old boy named Harold, who decided to take a journey, drawing everything that he needed and wanted along the way. You see, everything was possible for him with his purple crayon. What if everything was possible for you? All you needed to do was draw. What if you could have everything you long for, dream of, desire, wish, and all you needed was a purple crayon? Today I'm going to show you that you and every one of us has a purple crayon to begin to draw our ideal career, life, and dreams. As you know, Kate Hagerty and I spent over 30 years in corporate America generating multi-million dollar contracts for Fortune 500 companies like Sears and Roebuck, LexisNexis, and Showtime Networks. And during my career, I won some awards, but the only one I ever cared about was called the Pony Award. The Pony Award was named after share with you that move resulted in my income going from 6 figures to 4 and deep into the earth. There were no Pony Awards this time. No, I figured I had 3 options. I could consolidate my debt, I could file for bankruptcy, or, cringe, return to corporate America, which is what I did. And it's still really hard for me to say that out loud and share it with people. Because I'm an accomplished, smart business person. I know how to grow a business and generate money. But when this happened, it was a huge, painful, anxiety-ridden wake-up call for me that I needed to pick up my own purple crayon, begin to draw a plan, and start so that I could start living my best, authentic life. So there may be some of you who, like me, have something you'd rather not admit to. Could be something you see as a failure or a missed opportunity, wrong decision. Some of you may be putting your lives on hold in order to put everybody else first. And still others of you may have no idea what you're passionate about. Maybe you knew at one time, but not now. And then there's still you'll discover that you, what is possible for you and for your life without sacrificing yourself. You'll discover that you too have a purple crayon, just like Harold, and you'll have an opportunity to connect with me. So to finish the story about the five-year-old twin boys, one is a pessimist, one is an optimist. Their parents couldn't understand how two kids who were so alike were also so different. And so they took them to a psychiatrist. The psychiatrist took the pessimistic twin into a big room piled high with brand new toys, expecting the boy to be thrilled. But instead he walked in and he looked around and he burst into tears. And the psychiatrist said, "What's wrong? Don't you want to play with the toys?" He just looked up and said, "Well, yeah, but I know if I do, I'm just going to break them." Next, the psychiatrist took the optimistic twin into a different room piled high. In, he passed the doorway and he clapped his hands and he ran to the top of the pile and he started shoveling the manure over each of his shoulders. And the psychiatrist said, "What on earth are you doing?" The little boy stood up, put his hands on his hips, and he said, "Well, I figure with all this horse poo, there's got to be a pony in here somewhere." So I don't share that story with you just so you know how the pony award got its name. I share it with you to have you ask yourself, which twin do I identify with? Which twin do I identify more with? And you may think you know, and maybe you're not sure. It might depend on the circumstances. But I'll bet even if you think you know, more will be revealed to you by considering these next three questions. And these three crucial questions are what you need to ask yourself to begin to get on purpose and on track. The first question you need to ask yourself is, where am I? And there are handouts here so that you can fill them out as we go and take that with you at the end so you'll have something to refer back to. But the first question is, where am I? And when you ask yourself that question, what's your answer? You know, some of you might say, if I'm honest, I actually feel kind of stuck, maybe a little miserable. And if I'm honest, depressed, I just don't know what I'm supposed to be doing, but I know it's not what I'm doing now. And others might say, hey, I'm ready, I just need a plan, I need specific steps to follow, and hey, it'd be great to have somebody to be accountable to during that process and to support me. And then still others that I meet will have tried really, really hard not to have to answer the question at all. And instead, they can find themselves drinking too much, eating too much, perhaps having trouble sleeping, or just withdrawing altogether because it takes everything they have just to get through the day. I lived like that for years. Your answer to this first question leads directly to the second one, which is, what is my true life purpose? Why should I care? What is my true life purpose and why should I care? Motivational speaker Les Brown put it so well when he said, you are being called to live a bigger life. Answer the call. Your playing small does not serve you. And it's true. When we get what I like to call love nudges, little jolts in life, and we don't pay attention to those, or we ignore them or whatever it is, they don't go away. They just get bigger. And that love nudge turns into a love shove. And a love shove can feel like, or be, a job loss, a relationship that breaks up, somebody that passes, something that happens in your life to get you to stop and really take a look at it. And if people miss it then, this is where sometimes they'll start to have some serious health problems. Because let's face it, when you end up on your hands and knees or literally flat your back in the hospital, you will eventually find yourself asking, what am I doing with my life? What am I doing with my life? And that's exactly the point. So one of my favorite tools that I like to use to help clients answer that question is to take a look at something called their birth path number. Using just their birth date, I'm able to see both their hidden and obvious gifts and talents, plus what their unique capacity for success is. So your birth path number is based on your birth date, and what it reveals are those unique gifts and traits and talents that you were born with, and you came here intending to share with the world by fulfilling your purpose. But sometimes we forget what they are. Or sometimes they're things that are easy for us and we're like, meh, not a big deal. But they are a big deal because they're not easy for everybody else. And still other times, while we might have that capacity, ability within us, maybe we haven't let it come up and out yet. Maybe we haven't discovered it. So there are 12 different birth path numbers, and so more than we have time to cover today, but I did get some volunteers to share their birth path numbers with you, and they're going to be finding out what their birth path number is at the same time you do, which will be most fun.
First
we have Miss Amy. And Amy is a birth path six. So the sixes are here. They're often drawn to work for social consciousness. I should say global consciousness, and they'll often want to work for justice and social order. And when they show up, they bring with them peace and harmony. They're great teachers and great collaborators. The biggest telltale sign of a six is that home and family are number one. They will rearrange their life so that home and family are you know, what they need to be. Meredith Vieira is a six. So she left 60 Minutes. She left the Today Show because it wasn't number one for her. Being home for her family and her husband was. So some other birth path six celebrities that we know, Goldie Hawn.
Oh, I love her.
And I'm pretty sure she was interviewed at one point and she was like, oh, it's never been about the you know, show type stuff. It just hasn't been. It's been fun, but it's more about family. Britney Spears and I guess what, Justin Timberlake. They could have made it. So the other thing is that sixes tend to put everybody first and give. They forget sometimes about themselves. So you have to make sure you take time for you. Next we have Ms. Emily. Emily, and actually Paul, who's going to be here, are the same number. You guys are both birth path nines. So the nines tend to be drawn to humanitarian work, service-oriented causes. They have a wisdom about them because they've usually gone through some tough stuff, and so they have compassion for the human condition, and this makes them very charismatic. They are leaders. They're compassionate. They have an insight, and they intend to do work that inspires others to get through something tough that they themselves have gone through. And so their path is about letting go of the past, looking forward with grace, and usually helping others to do the same. So the nines that are celebrities we know would be Jimmy Carter, look what he's done, Harrison Ford, Robert Redford, whose catalog is like always giving money to charity, and Shirley MacLaine. And then we have Dan the Man over there. Dan is a birth path eight. And the eights are here. Their path is around power and wealth. What do they do when they have it? Do they use it to empower others? Do they use it to fund causes they care about? The eights are here for big ideas, entrepreneurialism. If you started out in a cube world, Dan, you wouldn't have stayed there very long because you would have had big ideas and been a strong leader, which would allow you to move right up the ranks to become the CEO, or guess what? Leave and have your own company altogether.
Hey, yeah. You just get that from my birth date?
Yes. And we haven't really talked, right?
No.
Yeah. Wouldn't know all this stuff about you guys. So yeah, you're here to think big and use your power and wealth for great things.
You're still working on the power and wealth part? But the thinking big, yes.
Sometimes the eights have a lot or none. Yeah. And it's they're in there figuring it out. Yeah.
I always say I'm $1 million away from being a millionaire. So it's still, unfortunately.
Well, it's a powerful birth path, and once you put your mind to something, you'll accomplish it.
Thank you.
All right. So in the eights that we know, Muhammad Ali, Paul Newman, Matt Damon, Martha Stewart. So not, you know, small personalities. Do these feel like they kind of fit?
Yes.
Sometimes when I've done like group parties, people are like, oh my God, I just totally feel so exposed. You know? So if you're not sure what your purpose is, finding out your birth path number can be really helpful. Finding out what it is can be really helpful because it will shed light on maybe what you've come here to do, who you've really come here to help. So that's what that was. I skipped it. Oops. So why should you care about your true purpose? Because when you align your life with it, that's when the good stuff shows up. Success, abundance, and happiness. It is possible to love what you do, to have your work make a difference in the world, and to earn a good living doing it. It's possible for every one of us, although really there are some people that don't believe it, that it is possible. My work in the world is to help others discover their purpose and what are those specific next steps they need to take to begin to align their life with what they really came here to do and who they really came here to help. I also have what some would call intuitive gifts.
So most people hear about the word clairvoyance, which is the gift, the ability to see. There are a lot of different intuitive gifts. The ones that you tend to hear the most about are the ones that, kind of as a group, are called the clairs. The intuitive ability to see, hear, feel, and know. And I have all four. They just kick in differently depending on what I'm doing. But it's that combination of the corporate background, the certification as a coach, and my woo-woo stuff that makes me a little different than another coach. Okay, so here's the thing. In order for change to occur, what needs to happen? Change. And here's what I know. Change, fear, go hand in hand. Even when you're making the absolute right and best decision. Even when. I remember learning that from someone who's a little older and wiser. She said, oh, okay, there'll be fear. Because it'll be something you haven't done before. Well, I was really bummed to learn that, to hear that, because I thought, I'm going to know. I'm going to be confident, clear, I won't have fear, and that's how I'll know what to do, right? No. When we start to consider real change, true transformation, that's when monkey mind shows up. Monkey mind is that voice that says, no one's going to want to eat at your restaurant. No one's going to want to read your book, and who do you think you are to even consider? That voice. Monkey mind's job is to make sure that nothing ever changes. That everything stays exactly how it is right now, forever. So, how's that working for you? Yeah, you'll know when it's time to make a change because your discomfort level, your anxiety level, will become so high that it's just intolerable for one more minute. Okay, so this brings us to the third question. I'm uncomfortable. What can I do? So the great news is there are many actions that you can take to begin to align your life with your purpose. I'm going to cover three with you today. And the first most impactful, I'm going to get a prop, the first most powerful action you can take is to immerse yourself in gratitude. And why gratitude? Because it works like a magnet. It opens up your heart and it brings in more things to be grateful for. The more you're grateful for, the more that you have and that comes into your life to be grateful for. So how can you immerse yourself more deeply into gratitude? Start a gratitude jar. So inside here are little slips of paper. Write down the things you're already grateful for and add them to the jar. As more things happen or that come to you, you add those to the jar as well. And so, if you have a tough day, you might need to read a couple of them. But the point is, this is something you might want to do once a week, a quarter, a year, whatever works for you. The point is, by immersing yourself in gratitude, you change and shift who and what comes into your life. The next one, this is a biggie, is to listen to your thinking. What? What do I mean when I say that? Most of us are familiar with the concept that what we think about, we bring into our experience. It's also called the law of attraction. In the book, The Secret, how many of you read it? Have read it? Okay. In the book, The Secret, Rhonda Byrne refers to that law of attraction as the genie. The genie assumes that what you're thinking about, you want. That what you're having action around, you want, and that what you're talking about, well, you want that too. The genie doesn't question your commands. The genie doesn't care if it's something that you want or don't want, if you think it's right or wrong. If you're thinking about it, taking action around it, guess what the genie is going to serve up? So a lot of us have these negative thought loops that have perhaps been running for years, and we don't even notice them anymore. But we have to. We have to catch those negative thoughts and turn them into something positive. And then when you are able to do that and add visualization to it, and you do that on a regular basis, it's very powerful. So say, for example, I have a negative thought of things never work out for me, or I can't afford it, I don't have money. And I switch it over to, I what will it look like to have my ideal car? What will it feel like to have my ideal relationship? What will people say to me when I? So you add in the bits. And I want each of you to grab three. And what you're going to put down are, what are the three things that you hear when you start to consider change or sometimes it's I have to be perfect. I can't do it. I never get what I want. I don't deserve it. It's whatever pops in your mind. So you probably won't have to think about it too long. So just one on each sticky. I'll give you a second to do that.
Or we can drag one over
on
there.
Front. Strongest one for you, and you're going to grab a new post-it.
ahead and do that. Let me ready.
Need help.
Look up.
With that. I'm kidding.
Okay.
I've been real, seriously, I've been mulling this over for a long time.
All right. I'll take
trying to figure out. And you can speak it out loud. I don't care. I'm not ashamed of it.
I own it.
Yeah. Well, a lot of financial return. And so it could be something like all the people I work with can afford me and decide quickly and easily. Money is not an issue for everyone I work with. You know, just
okay.
Make it.
Got
yeah.
it.
I work with people who
that
can
helps.
Easily afford me. I work with people who price is never an issue.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cool.
That helps.
Alright, so you guys, have you share your new ravingly positive statement with each other?
I'm not good.
Okay.
Alright, so for mine, I took the one really work. You know, because it's kind of, if it doesn't work, I feel, dang
it. You look like you're
so
having
a Haas. I wrote,
the brain's like,
most of my ideas work because they are well thought out, awesome, and when I commit, they succeed.
Yeah. And
so,
what did I write down? Big ideas. Think big.
Yeah.
Can you go first? Can I make
yeah.
a comment about that?
Sure.
Yeah.
You said most.
I turned this one into
yeah.
the.
So,
the last
to
year.
Me, it feels like you're still learning.
Well, I guess what I mean is,
that's what I was
I'm not afraid of failure. A lot of like
mm-hmm.
if you succeed, you're going to fail. But that's like 90% of the time I don't. So that's a really good. So I don't mean most like in a week, but
oh,
only
okay.
like literally like
I
have experienced failure 90%
okay.
of the time. Right? It's
I wrote, I'm a powerful lion.
So why am I scared? Because most people experience failure a lot more. So,
okay.
so it's more of a strong most.
Ooh,
than
okay.
Than
nice.
Than
nice.
Than
I like that.
That's
right?
what it is.
Okay.
you know,
yeah.
it's more
okay.
like a, literally 90% of the time. And even like my, I was thinking specifically about. Full day, 9-hour training 2 years ago when we were trying to kick this off. We only got like 7 people there and only 3 paid.
Did you all get a chance to go?
I felt like a
no.
failure.
We're still the same today.
Yeah.
But the point of it is, it's a fucking failure. But that was just the first step. That was like
a, I had
this,
a client.
That was like,
I had a client.
Yeah.
That was just
was
a battle.
Upset,
it wasn't a war. If you were
like,
that was just
yeah.
like,
I was like,
that was a step, but it wasn't like, means I failed.
Right.
Just means
I
was like, I learned.
I don't want to pay
yeah.
you that little.
Okay. So that was
okay,
cool. Even was my failure. Because
yeah,
I went in front of
you. You know, sometimes when you get
yeah.
knocked down, and then you're like,
good. Okay, life is
thank
a
you.
Fun adventure in which good things happen
it,
all
like,
the time.
How is this $50?
Yeah.
If I lower it by $50,
say it a bunch. I might.
The difference between.
It's not about the money.
Most of the time.
Never really is.
Maybe I'll, yeah.
Most
of
the okay,
time.
But the positive
yeah.
most, not the negative.
So you believe in your services. It's a tough one.
Yeah.
Everyone's struggling with
it.
The
Amy seems to live
more than
us. 2 years most is a bad thing.
I'm just saying.
I know, that was good. That was
yeah.
good feedback. Very good.
I work with only people who love to pay for training and decide quickly. Is that good?
Yeah.
Did
yeah.
I transform
wait,
that?
But which one was that against?
People
can't afford my services.
So we've talked about the power of gratitude,
and the importance of your thinking, and I told you it was going to give you an opportunity to connect with me, and that's what this postcard is for. This is for what I call an Unleash Your Yes session. It is a complimentary 45-minute session over the phone. And so if you're interested, you just put name where it says name, email where it says email, birth date, believe it or not, where it says that, and that's just so I can take a look at your birth path number, and your phone number in case I can't read your writing, because that does happen. Under that are three goodie boxes. The first says, yes, I would like this complimentary session. The second is, I'd like your free gift, which is something separate from that. And so if you check either one of those first boxes, I have to send you an email so you can be connected to my online calendar and get the link to the free gift. And then the bottom one is, I know of a great place that would want to hear what we're talking about today. So, the reason that I do what I do, and I didn't say this until this year, is because I grew up in a household where I felt invisible. I felt invisible, not seen, not heard, not valued, and so it is my passion to help as many people as I can to know that I see you, like you're visible, and you have immense value. In fact, you came here with unique gifts and talents that no one else can deliver to the world the way you do. And the people that you came here to help, the people you came here to serve, they're waiting for you. And so in front of you is your purple crayon. And I encourage you to take it with you today and put it somewhere where you're gonna see it all the time. And I just wanna back up 1 second about this call to be really clear about the session, what it is and what it isn't. You know, I mentioned earlier that I have these intuitive gifts, so sometimes people are like, oh my God, it's a free psychic reading. No. It has happened. So the intuitive gifts come later. This is gonna be a conversation about you. Where do you feel the most stuck, and are you ready to take action around it? So this session is for someone who's is miserable and feels stuck. It's like, I've done everything I know to do on my own, and now I just know I need some outside help. Or the person who's just like going through the motions, enduring, existing, not really living. Because we didn't come here just to endure. We came here to live, and we came here to thrive. And that call is also for someone who's a doer. And they regularly take action to improve their life, and they're ready to say yes to themselves and to see what it's going to be like to align their life with their purpose. So just wanted to clarify that. Now with the crayon, like I said, you might be tempted to leave it here, but I encourage you to take it. Put it somewhere where you're going to see it every day as a reminder that you do have a choice. You can begin to draw the life you've always dreamed of, or you can stay where you are, but you do have a choice. Thank you. So just stick around afterwards if you have questions to collect your cards.